Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Monaco Formula One Grand Prix winner, two-time Indy 500 winner, and three-time Daytona 24 Hours winner, Juan Pablo Montoya.
How are you?
Welcome on stage, champion.
Thank you.
Happy to have you here at the Frankfurt Show. And it's a proud honor for us.
No, for me.
With us.
I mean, for me, it's incredible to be here. I want to welcome everybody here. It's when, you know, when Bugatti told me, you know, do you want to come and do this? It's like, really? Do I really get the chance to do this? It was unbelievable.
Well, I think you locked it in. Well done. Great job. And now we are some weeks after you did it. How do you look back to the event?
Looking back at the event, it was incredible because the car is so stable. It's so predictable. And at the same time, it's so fast. It really is. I tell people, you know, when I was in Formula One and we had to do manual starts, a good 0-100 was 2.7. This does 2.4.
It's an unbelievable time. So when you arrived in Wolfsburg, you came with big bags, carrying all your gear, helmet and tons and everything. And then you drove in the car without the racing gear in a white shirt. Why that?
So we got there, you know, they made a really nice Bugatti uniform and everything. It was really, really nice. I thought, oh my God. And then, you know, I got to the track and we tried the car and I said, why? Why the uniform? For me, it made no sense because, I mean, when you buy the car, you can do 420. We're only going to 400. So what's the point?
Your decision. So to lock in the 42 seconds, how many attempts did it take you?
It only took me two attempts. I did 17. It only took me two.
That's great. It's really amazing. And I heard that in between you had some free laps. Yeah. And you also improved your personal top speed record. Is that true?
Yeah, it's true. So one of the reasons with the 17 attempts was when we did it the first day, it was warm. And being warm is good because the air is thinner, so you go a little quicker. We tried the next day in the morning. We would accelerate a lot quicker to 300, but from 300 to 400 with the conditions were not ideal. So while we were doing that, they said we're going to wait that it gets a little warmer. So while we waited, I wanted to see how fast I could go. Before, back in the day in the IndyCar, at the beginning when we had the big engines, we were doing 407 on the draft. Big draft, like, I was really quick. And because after that, now we only do like 380. So I thought, let's see how fast I can go. And I got to 420 because it's limited.
What happened at 420?
It sits in the limiter. It's terrible. I mean, yes, you're going really quick. But, you know, when you drive your normal car, you know, and any car and you get, you know, they're limited to 260, this limits at 420.
Well, but I can assure you there will be more. As you could see in the video, there was a little glance about what's happening in the future. And we intend to lock in a new world speed record
in
2018. And my question to you is, are you in?
Oh, absolutely. You know, an opportunity like this.
Okay.
Honestly, anybody can drive this. When I did the run, I told him, "I thank you for inviting me. Thank you for letting me drive the car. But you could have done it."
Yeah, but this was only the warm-up for you. It is going to happen next year, and I think then you really need to hang in. And today, I would like to present to you a little trophy. A true racer, when he makes a record, needs a trophy. So there is the Bugatti Elephant, and it says Juan Pablo Montoya, 420 kilometers per hour, his new personal speed record, Era Lesin, 16th of August, 2017.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you very much for being with us. And you're a true champion.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us today. And please stay tuned for the next record drives that will happen at Bugatti in the near future. Vive la marque.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Bugatti Chiron. 0-400 kilometers per hour in 42 seconds. A world record.